for another session where in today's class, this is part 11. In today's class, we'll discuss about the classification of, in the previous class, we have in detail, we have discussed about the characteristic feature of bryophyte, right? So now we'll discuss about the classification of bryophytes. The classification of bryophytes. So actually, there is a person called as Roth Mallor has classified the bryophytes into three different classes. Roth Mallor classified the Roth Mallor classified bryophytes into three different classes. Which are those on the consider Maradaga? Once we look into the classes concerning with respect to the bryophytes, which are those on Tandaga? First and foremost, Hepaticopsida. Anthoceropsida, and the third one is Bryopsida. Hepaticopsida, Anthoceropsida, and Bryopsida. So first we'll look into the Hepaticopsida now. So how exactly we are going to distinguish them? The first one, yaudro, Hepaticopsida. Remember, the Hepaticopsida are commonly known as So the Hepaticopsida are commonly known as the liverworts. Enanta heltivi navu ke liverworts anta heltivi. We call them as liverworts. Why these are called as liverworts? Yake members of Hepaticopsida now liverworts anta heltivi appa antandre, because now inna ish bardena andre neevu rashta barkondirthiri. These are called as liverworts because their thallus appear to be as lobes of the liver. Their thallus resembles lobes of the liver. Their thallus resembles the lobes of the liver. Liver in lobes idukettena irthada. For that say idukku naave en anta heltivi liverworts anta heltivi. Especially these liverworts, these liver worts usually grow in moist soil, shady areas. Moist soil, shady areas such as banks of a stream, marshy ground, damp soil. Such as banks of a streams, I mean to say banks of the streams, marshy ground, damp soil,
And even they are going to go over the bark of the trees, marshy ground, bank of the streams, marshy ground, damp soil, bark of the trees, and deep in the wood, deep in the wood. Next one. The body of liverworts is thalloid. The body of liverworts is thalloid. Thallus, which is, what is thallus? The body cannot be divisible into root and shoot system. Example, bekambari bodni markentia antanthe idr munda thalloid. Example, rickettsia and markentia. Na baridinalle general characteristics berbekar baridinalva rickettsia and markentia. You can write the markentia as an example. The thallus is dorsiventral and closely appresses to the substratum. So the thallus is dorsiventral. The thallus is dorsiventral, closely appresses to the substratum. Andre no, for example, hanga pa antandre is type dorsiventral agirtade idu soil anta consider madri flat agi enagirutappa antandre soil hattine irutade closely appresses to the substratum. Elle moist soil irabodu like wood irabodu bark of the individual plants irabodu idu substratum antandre adu exactly very near to the substratum, it is totally closely attached. Adakken hattirappa annanga grow aagtiruttadu hoda. So neevu internet olaga structure of markentia anta hodidrappa antandre structure of markentia hodiri, habitat of markentia anta hodiri, markentia anta hodiri, you will get the habitual condition. Closely appresses to the substratum. Clear? Next, the leafy members have tiny leaf like appendages, as in case of porella. Porella helide nanu leafy members which is having a leaf like structures, right? The portion of the thallus below the air chamber consisting of several compactly arranged parenchymatous cell which will help in the storage of food material and all. Especially once we look into the thallus, below the thallus there will be a presence of rhizoids, right? Thallus is dorsiventral, has rhizoids, right, which will help them to attach to the substratum. And usually these individual aspects, the rhizoids irabodu, and over that there will be a dorsiventral leaf structures in antaitala adu irabodu. So that has been produced over the just below the dorsiventral region of the leaf like structure, which will help them to attach to the substratum. Since they are greenish in color, they will perform the process of photosynthesis. Clear? They will perform the process of photosynthesis. And there are certain specialized structures which are present below the certain thallus, below the air chambers near olaga, there are certain parenchymatous cells which are present there. Those parenchymatous cells that will help in the storage of food material. Photosynthesis martho food na store madoda avada pa antandre certain parenchymatous cells are found in the thalloid region. So actually these members illi barithe nodri, next we will move on for the next character. These members, they will show asexual reproduction by producing a specialized cup shaped structures called as gamma cup. So I'm going to draw a diagram right over here. Consider this is structure of
Markenchia.
Clear? So here there will be a rhizoids which have been attached to the substratum. Ille.
Over the thallus, there will be the production of specialized cup-shaped structures. What we are going to call them as gamma cup. Remember, these
are the structures which will help to carry out the process of asexual reproduction.
Yeah, particular aspect to in the Markenchia. Remember, in the Markenchia, there are certain specialized structures which will help in the process of asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction madaka specialized structure ada a structure gena enu anta heltivi gamma cup anta heltivi. This gamma cup produces a specialized dumbbell shaped structure. Kelabekam barbodru anta the gamma cup has dumbbell shaped dumbbell shaped structures, dumbbell shaped structures called as gamma, not yamma, gamma. Yanta structure hai idrulaga. Within this there will be a presence of dumbbell shaped structures called as gamma. Yenavo gamma? Yamme namma hemme adula. So gamme antandre these are the vegetative propagules. On germination of this gamme, there will be a one more gametophyte, it will be produced. Clear? So asexually reproduction agudange by producing gamme. These gamme are become bari the gamme are green multicellular asexual birds. These gamme are green multicellular asexual birds. On germination gives rise to new gametophyte. Barere, these gamme are green multicellular asexual birds. On germination gives rise to new individual gametophyte. Next, sexual reproduction is carried out by producing gametophyte on different either same or different thalli on either same or different thalli. Thalli and the plural thallus in thalli. Then you know male gametophyte and the consider male male thallus in the consider madre only anthridiophore matra hondirtad innond thallus bartadu baju adu archegoniophore matra hondirtad na helidine alli explain madidine already. Clear? So like that we are going to find the structures. So igenagtada the process, it will be continued. So what kind of process? The process of reproduction. What kind of reproduction? The sexual reproduction. As we all know that the process of sexual reproduction, it will be carried out by antherozoites, right? Which is a haploid. What is this? A haploid male gamete which is motile, which is having two flagellas, right? And over the female gametophyte, there will be the presence of female gametophyte. Tell me, female gametophyte is present in the archegoniophore, which is having archegonia. Within that archegonia, there will be a presence of egg cell, right? So this is haploid, motile, flagellated anthrozoite. It will reach us egg cell with the help of water. Explanation kodidini nanu, just rough agi helthidini, right? In detail we have discussed this all the concept. So which leads to the production of, which leads to the process of what? Fertilization, right? This fertilization leads to the production of zygote. This zygote develops into embryo. This embryo develops into sporophyte, which is parasitic, diploid, dependent over the gametophyte. This sporophyte is going to produce what? It is going to produce the haploid spores. Idana clear ayi kalthidini naavu. These spores on germination gives rise to a neo gametophyte, right? That's how the life cycle it will be continued here. So this is what all about. Nodre difference nodre, idana baradiddappa antandre bahala start aagutitu, just kalisidini one sir, adu sambandha. I took a lot of time to explain the sexual reproduction. Neevu correct aagi kelilappa antandre it's your wish. If at all you didn't, you know, got it, go and observe that one more time. Watch that one more time. Mundu ive process proceeding akonde hogutada holambala holambala. Clear? So new generation continuation aagutada. So in case of your examples nodavattappa antandre Markensia, Rickettsia, Porella, you can write example baribodu Markensia, Rickettsia, Porella. Clear? So these are the very good examples. These spores on germination gives rise to a free living gametophyte. Free living gametophyte. This is what all about the bryophyte. In the next session, we'll discuss about Anthroceropsida and Bryopsida. Clear in detail again. All the discussion. Thank you so much.